this session with three presentations. After this, we will have a discussion like the one we had. We will have two groups discussion. One group discussion. So let's start, and thank you very much for... Who's going to start there? Thank you. First, I would like to thank you all for coming here. I'm very happy that today I met with all friends like Elena and Takashi and Russell.
去年我们参加了马来西亚的伊夫拉年会，然后在会议上的时候，季祥德博士在会议上就地中国方地方志做了主旨报告，让很多人了解了我们中国地方志。
Last time in Malaysia, we also talked about the local chronicles museums, and we discussed more about it. And now we are here to discuss.
大家都知道，那个世界上有四大古文明，古中国、古巴比伦、古埃及、古印度，四大文明，只有中国文明传承至今。地方志为中国文化的传承做出了很大的贡献。 中国有一个古话叫“国有史，方有志，家有谱”。地方志作为地方百科全书，它是一种中国独有的一种文化传承载体。它不同于地方史，不同于历史。地方志真实地记录了一个地方区域内自然、政治、经济、文化、社会的资料性的一个文献。
地方志在中国有2000多年的历史，从隋代起，一直延续至今。 Local chronicles museums have a long history in China since 2000 years ago, when there was the first establishment of this kind of institution, up till today.
我知道今天参加会议的很多都是图书馆界的专家，大家之前有听说过档案馆、博物馆，还有图书馆，但是我想了解一下，在座有没有之前听说过方志馆？
Everyone here are involved in business with libraries, so you all have heard about this kind of museums and archives.
Okay, we will try to do our best to introduce you to the
show you some of the examples in China.
Local
Chronicles Museums not only collect books about the particles, but they also have they are multifunctional. They have they also compile and edify, and they have different functions like they also have field network centers and trainings.
下面是先简单介绍一下它的那个发展背景。宋代以前，当时的方志馆是主要是依附在各类编修机构、各种藏书楼的形式存在。然后，因为那时候还没有真正意义上的方志馆。
In the beginning in Sweden, when they started collecting these particles, it was done in the simple way. This was a long time ago, and they just the most of the things they did was compiling.
从宋代开始的话，地方志日渐成熟了，然后也逐渐定型了。这样的很大的推动了独立方志机构的发展，特别是北宋九律图志局的成立，标志着中国历史上独立志书编纂机构的正式成立。
Experienced fast development, and they became there were a lot of the other prime mirrors, and they were developing since until today.
清朝呢是中国方志发展史上的鼎盛时期，也是中国方志馆发展的一个很重要的时期。
In the Qing Dynasty, also these kind of museums were very important, and they compiled a lot of kind of museums, and they became a very important part of both the country, growing the country, and also military purposes and so
on. 浙江决定续修浙江通志，还建设立了浙江通志局，作为中国近现代史上的第一个省级地方志机构，方志馆机构。然后，它的创立就是对中国方志馆事业做出了开创性的贡献。Especially
in the 1941, when was established the first of this kind of local chronicles museums, was important for. It was the first one of such kind in the Republic of China that follows the same, and today we follow the same principles that were established there.
特别是中华人民共和国成立了以后，各地都新建方志馆，然后在以前中国地方志它主要是编修一本书，然后到现在。就是发展成了，也是前所未有的一个黄金时期，在地方志事业发展上，对。
Especially after economic reform and the opening up of China, these kind of local chronicles museums experienced such popularity and development in the country.
特别是现在方志馆的建设也是加快了步伐，也是有了很大的发展。就截止到去年年底，我们有过统计，在中国建立省市县各级方志馆有603家。
Today there's these kind of museums spread across the whole country, and there are 661 total in China.
方志馆呢，它跟那个其他的一些场馆。有一定的联系，也有区别，就是在很长一段历史时期的话，藏书楼、图书馆这些场所也是担任了一些方志馆的部分功能。
As I said before, this kind of local chronicles museums have some similarities with other cultural facilities like libraries and cultural centers, but also have some specific features that belong only to them.
但是相对于方志馆来说，这些场馆他们只是展示的是历史的一个点或者是一个面。
especially when these facilities only represent history or culture or they usually represent only one aspect.
然后那个方志馆呢，它作为地勤馆来说的话，它的特色在于全面和专业。
But the local chronicles museums, they are multifunctional and they have a lot of they have a lot of both characteristics and functions.
全面主要是它全面展示了一个区域内的所有情况，人们可以通过方志馆了解到当地的历史啊，包括一些文化，然后起到了其他场馆就是有一个互补的作用。
Because they have all these.Historical, environmental, and cultural aspects, people can experience what conditions were at that specific time when they go to visit these kind of museums. And this can serve as a supporting institution for other facilities.
专业的话，它主要展现的是本地区的一些特色地形文化，这些也是其他公共文化设施所不能替代的。
These other facilities like cultural facilities, they only represent cultural aspects. But when someone goes to chronicle museums, local chronicle museums, they can experience more.
下面我给大家展示一些就是中国方志馆的一些建设情况。下面我给大家展示一些那个中国有特色的方志馆。
Now I will show some pictures of Chinese local chronicles museums.
这个是国家方志馆。
This is National Chronicles Museum.
对。这个图片是国家方志馆那个成立的时候揭牌仪式。你看，这个是季祥德先生、邱新玉先生今天也在现场。
On the first photo, you can see the opening of the National Chronicles Museums, and on this photo, our director of the National Chronicles Museums, Dr. Jens季祥德 and Qiu Xinyu, both present here.
对，然后国家方志馆有两个展览比较有特色，一个是方志中国，它介绍了中国地方志的发展历史，还有一个是魅力中国，介绍了中国的国情、地情。对。
This museum is divided into two parts. The first one is local chronicles museum, which, as I explained, represents all these aspects, and the other one is charming China.
是方志中国的，对，
是 charming China。
这个是魅力中国，展示一些那个一些自然地貌。
In China Hall, you can see beautiful Chinese sceneries.
展示中国的辉煌的成就。
And here in this part, the representation of historical events.
这是我们的藏书，这只是一部分。对，
十万多册。
这是国家方志馆的黄河分馆，国家方志馆下面有若干分馆，然后这个是在东营，东营是黄河入海口。
This is one branch of the National Chronicles Museums in Dongying City, the Yellow River Branch.
向人们介绍黄河文化。
They represent the culture of the Yellow River Base. This is the Educated Youth Branch of the National Chronicles Museum.
Beijing 市分方志馆。
Beijing Local Chronicles Museum.
它的特色在于互动性很强，有很多与观众能够互动的一些项目。
This one is specific because in Beijing Local Chronicles Museums there are many interactive activities.
数字方志馆也是我们现在的那个重点建设的那个对象。
There are also a lot of digital chronicles museums now active in China.
可以通过数字方式馆能够查阅到很多电子化的就制书年鉴电子化。
Many of the works have been digitized, so on these websites people can search for many of collections we have.
有的还通过三D 技术，然后展示实体放置馆。我们可以通过网上就能够感受到它实体放置馆的那个。
Yeah, in some ways, interested, you can find a lot of information about it.
常州放置馆。
常州放置馆，谢谢。
杭州方志馆就是有江南特色，对，
杭州
园林特色，江南园林。
This is also specific for the other part of China. Guangdong.
这些展览都非常受那个人们的欢迎，他们可以通过方志馆了解到当地的文化。
These photos, you can see how popular these museums are. A lot of people visit them regularly.
感谢你们的关注，然后也是很真诚的邀请各位，有机会能到中国，能够访问我们的方志馆。谢谢大家。
I'd like you all for attention, and I would hope that if you come to visit China, you would come to visit also these local chronicles museums.
请问大家对方志馆有没有什么问题？
Anyone has some questions about local chronicles?
We will have it after.
Thank you.
System for for communication through these levels, and it's a standardized system for everyone.
各机装置馆的共同的特点，都是来展示这个地方的自然、地理、政治、文化、社会的各方面发展的情况。
What we put a lot of effort in was to show China's natural, environmental, economic, and cultural aspects for people to see and to experience. Certain periods of time.
但是呢，各地和各地的方志馆又有很大的显赫不同，因为他们所处的位置啊、民族啊、文化、这个地理位置都有很大的差异，所以呢，方志馆在它的展陈内容上也有很大的区别。
But all these museums between themselves, they have a lot of differences because you know China is such so big, so depending on the location and nations that live in that part of China and events that happened in this part of China, there are so many differences.
这600多家方志馆是经常的相互交流。 全国就中国每年至少要组织一次工作经验交流，这600多家都要参加。除此之外呢，他们相互之间2个、3个、10个、8个、30、50个经常的交流。
They all have interactive activities, and every one of them more than 600.
而且呢，这个方志馆的建设在中国现在只是个开始，我们。 这个计划呢，再过几年，要在全国的每一个市、每一个市、每一个县，都要有这个展示这个地方地形的方阵。And
we still think that we are at the beginning. We hope that we will make for every city, every county, every region museum of this kind.
那时候可能将要建成这个至少4-5千个方阵，4-5千。
We have to make more than 4,000 museums.
我不知道这个回答这个问题没有。
And is there another question?
Are you part of the ICON or you have a leadership? And what programs are you incorporating in the library education, especially for the community
不是很清楚啊，但是我的理解呢，可能是，就是这个国我们这个国家这个各级的方志馆，是由一个统一的国家方志馆的建设规范，一个统一要求，省这一级应该怎么建，这个市这一级应该怎么建，县这一级应该怎么建，都有这一个这个统一的规定。那么在管理上，也是一个有个相对统一的管理的规范，但是呢，各地又有各地的不同情况。在管理上，就是对方志馆的管理，600多家嘛，各地全国的一个统一的管理规定，但是呢，各地呢也还可以有自己一些特殊的一些管理的方法。这个方志馆是中国自己独有的，就像地方志是世界上其他国家没有一样，所以呢，我们这个方志馆没有加入其他任何的组织。
No, we are not members, so we don't belong to any this kind of organizations.
那这下一步呢，它可以跟我们的图书馆啊、博物馆啊，可以建立一定的关联。
But all these have their specific provisions in management.
还有问题吗？
所有的材料都放在一个图书馆，一个地方志馆。
不是，我们是 这个我们的方舟馆不是方志图书馆，是它有存有所有的地方志书，但是它更大的功能是用这个地方志这种一种特殊的形式来展示这个地方的情况，不仅仅是放书。
When we talk about the local chronicles museums, what our idea is to make one for every region, every city, in order to represent this part of the natural and cultural aspects of that part of the China. So we don't centralize.
Thank you very much. If you have any questions,
好，谢谢。
Thank you, everyone. I'm very happy to hear, and thank you, Isla.
Thank you, Leila.
Thank you,
everyone.
Especially
thank you, Chess Leader.
Thank you.
Because I'm not good at English and Serbian, so I need a Chess Leader.
Thank you.
我用中文讲。我今天重点给大家介绍两个东西，一个是中国的地方史，还有一个是中国的地方志。
Today the main topic that I will discuss is. There are two topics that I will discuss. One is local histories, and another one is local chronicles.
中国呢是一个历史很长的国家。我们中国呢非常重视历史。
And we Chinese we appreciate a lot our history.
非常喜欢从历史当中吸取经验。
And also we like to draw lessons from our history.
所以我们有一个比较完善的史学的传统。
And we also develop this type of traditions.
我说我们有一个很完备的历史史学传统，主要是有几个方面。第一个呢，是我们有比较完备的史观。
One thing that is important when we talk about history are historiographers.
除了有史观呢，还有大量的史书。
Besides that, there are a lot of numbers of historical books and records.
同时呢，在不同的时代出现了好多很有成就的历史学家。
And also in different periods of time, a lot of historiographers had different ways of writing history.
这个图片呢，是我们中国比较早的一部古籍。
What you can see now is one of the ancient books of Chinese history.
叫周礼，是我们中国古代的一个大思想家，大家可能都知道，叫孔子，是他编撰的。
Probably all of you heard about Confucius. He's the one who compiled it.
这书里呢，记载了我们中国古代历史官员的一些设置情况。就是在古代就有很多历史官员专门负责记述历史的，就在这书里就记
述。In this book, a lot of historical events were recorded.
所以呢，中国人很早就开始特别重视历史，有设置的比较完善的史观是其中一个特点。
So as you can see, Chinese people from ancient times started to appreciate history.
比如说，我们有一句话叫“左史记年，右史记事”，意思就是说，一个历史官员负责记述活动。一个历史官员负责介绍他说了什么。
And we have a lot of sayings in our language that represent, for example, one historiographer will write about what he has done, and the other one will write about what he has said.
所以我们不同时代的历史都被完整的记录了下来。不同时代的历史都被完整的记录了下来。
Because of that, now we have a lot of different historical records today.
不同的时代都有不同的历史书。
Different periods have different historical books.
比较有名的一个呢，大家可以看到。我们中国历史上最有名的一个史官或者叫历史学家叫司马迁，他写了一部书叫《史记》。
The most important historiographer of China is Sima Qian. He wrote a history book, The Historical Records.
他这部书记录了中国大约3000年的历史，是从大约公元前3000年到公元122年。
This book recorded 3,000 years of history from 3,000 BC to 122 BC.
根据他这本书呢，中国历史上，我们叫正史，我们每一个朝代都有自己官方认可的一部历史书，我们统称叫24史。
Have been
based
on this book, and
every
dynasty has its own histories, as you can see,
we call them the 24 histories. 从第一部，刚才我提到的《史记》开
始，一直到大约300年前的 Ming Dynasty. Ming Dynasty history.
每一部史书，每一部书都是由官方认可，官方大部分是官方编写的。
Every one of them received officials.
历史学家也很多，上边我举了一些例子，都是中国的非常有名的历史学家。
In China, there are many historiographers, as I also mentioned before.
这是一个话剧的剧照，这里边这个人物就是刚才我提到的司马迁，他是中国最有名的历史学家。
This is one representation of Sima Qian at the theatrical stage.
这是他写的史记和他的一个属下。
These are collected historical records of Sima Qian and his sculpture.
那么中国的史学传统呢，有几个特点，有三个特点。
Chinese historical tradition has three aspects.
第一个是讲究客观经历。
The first one is writing. The historiographer should be objective and should write honestly.
第二个呢，注重从历史当中吸取经验。
The other one is to draw lessons from history and summarize experience.
第三个呢，就是强调写历史的人要有很好的品格。
The third one is that historiographer should have morality.
刚才我提到的是中国历史上的历史书，那都是记录一个国家的历史。下面我提到的是地方史，这个词今天我听到了很多次，很亲切。Local history.
What I've was talking about now was almost everything was the local histories, and all of this was written by these historiographers. And I would also like to talk about the local chronicles, which we heard about today.
在提地方史之前，我想先跟大家提地方志，也就是 Chinese local chronicles。地方史和地方志，只有一字之差，但并不是同一种东西。
Local chronicles and local history are not the same, but they have only one thing that differs them.
他们俩一直同时存在。
They exist simultaneously at the same time.
这是我找的一些图片，是我们的这个地方志。这些地方志是记录中国古代的，当时古代人，中国的古代人写的地方志。
These local chronicles represent ancient history and were written by people who lived in
it. 这是我们现代人写的，记录中国各地的地方志，这是省一级的地方志，我们还有县市一级，还有县一级。这三级的地方志都是由官方修撰编修的。
These are collections of provincial local chronicles. We also have municipal local chronicles, regional local chronicles.
这是我选了一本县一级的地方志，这里边是它的目录。这个目录里边可以看出地方志里边记的是什么。比如说有自然地理，
For example, natural landscapes.
有交通，
transport.
有工业，
industry.
甚至还有这个军事，
military,
文化，
culture.
体育，
education.
风俗。一个地方，一个行政区划内的所有的内容都能在地方志中找到。
These local chronicles record every specific aspect of that specific county.
但是地方志和地方史的区别到底在哪呢？我大致举了三点主要的区别。
But what is the difference between local chronicles and local history?
第一个就是地方志更注重记述当代的内容，是当代的人记录当代的事。
The first one is that the historiographer who is recording the local chronicles, he should record in the time that he is living.
第二点呢，地方志更强调的是。只是记述他所看到的、听到的和保存下来的这个基本的情况。
And he should also report facts and things that he has seen and heard at that specific.
地方史呢，除了记录的是以前的历史之外呢，还要对以前的历史事件、历史人物做一些评价。
Local history, the historiographer who is writing local history, he can also express his opinions and write his comments.
地方志就不会做评价，只记录。
Local chronicles, historiographers cannot write their own personal opinions and comments.
第三点呢，就是地方志，现在中国的地方志大多是由政府主持。
Current local chronicles in China have a lot of aspects about governing and political events.
地方史呢，更多的是由科研机构和学者编写。
地方史。
地方史。
histories are mostly written by academics and historiographers.
但是地方史的管理由我们来做。
But local chronicles, this is this is something that we do.
所以呢，规范的管理地方史的编写，就是一个很重要的一个任务。我们现在中国呢，我列了一下我的行政区划。中国现在省级行政区划有34个，包括台湾。市级的行政区划大约有333个，县级的行政区划有2844个。所以中国幅员辽阔，需要有这么多的地方行政区划，需要我们用地方史把地方的历史记录下来。
As you can see, China has 34 provincial administrative divisions, including Taiwan, 333 municipal administrative divisions, and 2,844 county administrative divisions. So, what we need is a lot of a big force that will be able to do this job of reporting local problems.
所以为了规范管理地方史的编写，我们起草了两个文件，一个叫地方史工作规定，一个叫地方史编写基本规范。
In order to be, for this work to be done properly, what we have done is we have written two guidelines for compiling local chronicles.
对于地方史编写的具体内容，做了，比如说，记录的原则、记录的内容、记录的方法、出版等等，做了一些具体的规定。
These provisions and norms include aspects that concern style and compilation methods and
publication. 大概就可以，不用讲那些。那个，下面我让大家看一些中国的地方史。这是一些中国出版的关于地方史的书。
These are some examples of local history books.
Next. Yeah. Go, 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 go. 这是中国各个地方自己编写出版的地方史。Province, 这是 city, county, 有不同的层级的地方史。
Historical books done at different levels. Some of them are provincial level, local history. Some of them are municipal levels.
和地方志一样，是两种东西同时存在。
And they exist at the same time with local chronicles.
这都是各式各样的中国的地方史。
These are all different types of local history books.
但是是一些专门的内容，比如说这个交通、文学、戏剧，各式各样的地方史。
But they refer to different aspects of Chinese culture and economics. Some of them are referring to transportation. Some of them.
下面这套书是中国的中国社会科学院编撰的一套书，它这书呢全面地介绍了中国所有的文化，包括物质的和非物质的。
These are all collections of Chinese brief histories of the different aspects of Chinese culture.
像有天文，有婚姻，有诗歌，
There is astronomy.
有水利，还有长城。它这里面也包括地方史，就是以行政区划作为技术内容的地方史。 新疆、武汉、锦州。刚才我讲的地方史是竖着记录了整个中国的历史，每一个地方中国的历史。地方志呢，又是记录了现在整个中国的发展情况，是一个横的，就是所有的行政区划的现状。
What the local chronicles are recording is the whole situation of one specific region in China.
所以在中国历史当中，中国人特别重视历史的记录。我们不光有史，还有志。所以我们要保证地方史的记述客观、真实、完备，就需要来规范管理他们的编写。谢谢。
In the end, we should try to be more objective and to summarize our experiences when writing local chronicles and writing the permissions we have provided. Thank you.
Thank you. Any question?
Now we have a question. It's very interesting actually the presentation, and I'm sure there's many questions. So I have a question. You talked about like 74 division or division China.
China has 56 nations in the, and they, some of them also have their own languages, and they could also write in their own language and then to be translated.
比如说内蒙古，他们有中文的当地的历史，记述当地历史的书，也有用蒙文记述他们当地的历史。
For example, in Inner Mongolia, in China, they also have records written in Chinese and in Mongolian.
Is there any comparative studies between local chronicles in different regions or in same regions but in different history, in different time in history? Just any kind of comparative studies.
地方志记录了一个城市从古代到现代所有的历史记录，这些历史记录都是最原始的材料，会有大量的历史学者会利用这些材料去做研究，专门研究中国一百年前和现在有什么不同，利用我们的这些材料去做对比。
Historical facts and everything to put in the current one. Thank you.
is a regular operation to each of the cities and towns. For the more content of the local chronicles standardized by the central government. For the what type of the standardization do you intend to have? Yeah, liberate a little more explain to the contents of the standardization.
For example, in Velvet, there is one of these kind of local chronicles museum. this museum not only possesses local chronicles, but when you enter, you can also see what people eat here, what kind of transportation they use, churches.